G'day viewers, welcome back to another video, Dudes, Dudesses. I know it's been a while. I've actually done some renovations here, but I've also got a lot of boards coming through now. And I'm doing one or two a month of quality boards, and I'm having a look at today something that you probably, hopefully you haven't passed over the thumbnail and you haven't actually skimmed over, because if you've got this far, I've got something to show you that's pretty awesome. And thinking outside the box, as typical Andrew Penman YouTube fashion, I'll show you something about this board that's really cool and why I'm recommending it and why I'm going to keep it myself. It's the Base Camp single hub drive 300 watt motor. Why am I doing that? I'll explain in a second, but let's get into it. The packaging is pretty incredible. As you can see, it's got a really premium sort of, get this out of here, I think I can. Okay, so straight away, looking at the box, it's a premium looking product. It's a really very nice looking product, as you can see. Packaging everywhere, very synonymous of the kind of the Boosted company and the way they used to package their boards. And I'll get the Boosted Mini up next to this to show you something interesting, and I'll go through a few things with you. First of all, this is a board brought to me today by Base Camp and by Steve and the team there, especially Tracy, who I've been dealing with. I decided to review this for a few reasons, and we'll go through them now. But basically, let's open and have a look at it and check it out. So I'll just show you what's in the box. So when you open the box, you'll see that it's nicely packaged, and it's got a nice feel to it, a nice finish. It's just beautifully packaged. Now this is the instruction booklet. Let's have a look at it. Oh wow. It's all gloss, it's all like a magazine, really high quality. This is actually okay, if you're gonna give this to a present for someone, when they look at it, they'll think it's a really high premium product. It's $299 US, free shipping, but it really has a feel and an energy about it, and a vibe that's really kind of expensive, which, you know, $299 is cool. This is the board, let's get it out, have a look at it, just show you there. It comes in with an awesome backpack. Rail guard, nose guard. This backpack is pretty cool because this at 5 kilos, it'll be really good to put on your back. That's super light. That's nearly as light as a normal skateboard. Let's get on the table, have a look at it, and give you my reasons why it's such a good board and why I'm going to keep it, and some secret stuff that you probably didn't think about with this board. Let's go through it now. Done. There you go. So the booklet, as I said, is high quality. It's all glossy. It's a first impression blow away thing because it's really, really nice. If you get it for a gift, that's just a nice finish on that. And as well as the remote, Ling Yi's got all their logos on there, all the writing. I haven't seen companies do that before. It's just a nice finish, a nice touch. Really beautiful, the charging little spot there where you charge it. It's got 4 adjustable braking and 4 adjustable speeds. So this is actually the current Ling Yi on this particular size motor. That is beautiful. The charger's a 1.5 amp. Yep, that's right. It's a 29 volt. You could probably get another voltage to do that and speed it up. But really, at the end of the day, it's only a 4 amp hour battery. You're going to charge it in a couple of hours from dead, probably. But yeah, that's a slow charge, is also good for your battery. So 1.5 is okay. Okay, the backpack and board holder, which goes through there, beautiful. Let me just point out the elephant in the room, that logo. That is epic. That is a really, really nice logo. I don't know who did it, but it's got a whole air of sort of opulence to it and good looking. It's just a nice, really quite a regal and quite funky logo. I do love that. I don't think that lends itself to anything, you know, cheap. It's a good looking logo. I love that. I think it's just it's beautifully done. This will be so handy. 5 kilograms, you could throw this on your back. and that'll be such an easier way of carrying it around. Let's look at the board. Okay, it's 74 centimeters long by 23 centimeters wide. If we put that into inches, that's 29 inches by 9.25 inches. The deck itself is a beautiful deck. This is what really I'm really impressed about. A beautiful U, concave in the middle. You haven't got the stupid spoon lip around there on the Booster Mini X that ruins your feet. Spin it around the back, you've got a beautiful deep scalloped out concave as it dips down to the big kicktail at the back, which is a bonus. And we'll go through that in a second. Wheels, it's sporting a 90 millimeter, 51 millimeter wide, 85 durometer. They look okay, but I think we're gonna can do it, something different with that on the front, but there's not a problem with that. This is it's gonna bed in well. This single reverse kingpin, and the bushings look a little bit tight. We can play around with those. There may be a little bit of wheel bite for my carving level. We'll see. If not, I'll pack it out a little bit with a couple of risers. I'll give you all the advice what to do if you're an advanced rider and you want to use this for what I'll talk about in a moment, which is the secret thing about coming along to this video and having a watch of this. I'll tell you why. Aesthetically, again, the bottom has got this beautiful circuitry sort of black finish emblem on the bottom. It just looks beautiful. I mean, that does not look cheap. That actually would second head turn think it's a Booster Mini X. It is a beautiful looking board. I'll be honest, I'm no Freddy. A mate of mine who's done, he's reviewed this. He gave it a really good thumbs up for its performance, so we can check that out in detail. But yeah, that's the actual deck. Now, it's punching a 4 amp hour battery. It's a 7S2P, so it's 14, 18, 650 batteries in parallel. That's 7 and 7. Not a huge battery, but you know, I think we're gonna get around about, I would say, 16 kilometer for the metric people. But you know, if you ride it gently and you're cruising on sort of NS speed, you'll probably get 18 kilometers, who knows. Top speed is 10 miles an hour, which is 16 kilometers per hour. I know Freddie got a 18, I think, miles an hour down a hill, slight hill, so he weighs less than me. I weigh 95 kilograms. We'll see how this goes. The limit for this is 100 kilograms. It's a great board for your daughter, your child, your grandchildren. It's got a very gentle curve. And because it's a small 300 watt motor on here, you're going to have a very, very forgiving, obviously, learning experience on this, because it's going to be quite good. In high speed, I think it'll have a bit of a bite. We'll check out the sound in a second. I mean, 300 watts does its job. This is not meant to be a long board for long range or power or group rides. I'll talk about what I think this board and its strong points are. I've got an acronym, it's APMAP, and it's the first one is availability, second is portability, maneuverability, agility, practicality, and price. So with those, no other board can come close. I mean, you can look at your Meepo Hurricanes and your Hayden Evolves. You're not going to get that kind of, you haven't got the, this just has the lightweight, you can carry it around. You've got this incredible, you know, availability. It can be in the back of your car. You know, I'm going to personally leave the back of my car when I'm on the way to a friend's house. We get pizza the other day. I had to drive 2 blocks away and walk. And I do usually take a skateboard, but I never did have one in the car. I didn't have electric scape in the car. This will be permanently in my back of my SUV, and I'll be taking out every time I go on the way. Just, it'll be like having a lunar module rover on the moon. It'll always be my car. It'll be part of my car, and you know, it'll just be what I take out to get around shopping centers. When I go to Home Depot or Bunnings, I have to park right at the other end. I'll just take it and chuck it in a trolley. It's such a good thing for that. I was working in the office environment 10 years ago, and I wore a suit. And in that, I used to just have to walk 2 kilometers. This would be bang on my backpack. I'd be there and like 2 minutes, 5 city blocks, have a coffee and raisin toast before I get to work, and I'd be still way ahead of walking. This is where it comes into its own. If you work in an environment like the airport or a university or a sports campus or academy, you're in a hospital situation or a big mailroom area or Amazon, or you just have a situation on building sites where you need to get across quickly, this is going to be like Marty McFly riding on a hoverboard. You'll just be able to pull this out and people will say, how'd you get there so quick? It's going to be incredible for that purpose. The last mile, the last 2 miles, in this case, 16 kilometers, 9 miles. It's great. It's pretty waterproof because of the hub motor, and the sealing on that bottom casing is beautifully done. So I really see that as a really first big asset for this board and why it should be included in your quiver. Number two, the next thing is a great gift. It's the polished finish of this with the booklet and the just the remote with all the coding and writing. It just is a nice, it looks like you spend a lot of money. So that is going to be great for learning, for young kids, for children, grandkids. My grandson will be riding this in 2 years. That's the second point it's so good for. And now, the drum roll. Now, I don't often use these, but let's lose them this time. This is my idea button, if you don't know. And it's a great idea for this board. And you know, people are going to say, oh, what are you doing, a single hub motor board, a 300 watt, something that probably people don't think about. And now I've started going to skate parks on my smooth stars and all my skateboards. There's also the runs, the speed runs. We have those little ramps. We're not talking about bowls or anything. We're talking about just nice big waves, and I'm loving it. But when you go to a skate park, you've got to understand that it's all based on one incredible scientific thing, and that's gravity. You're coming down a ramp, you've got to time and adjust and estimate your speed down the ramp to make the other side to get that point of no gravity. When you come back down again, it's really hard to sort of estimate that when you're not used to it. I like doing big carves on sort of wave ramps up to about 5 feet. But again, you've got to get the right speed up there. And if you go too fast, you've got no brakes. With this board, just think about this. You've got that little hub motor to give you the boost when you need it. You've got the braking to pull back when you need to. You've got a great clearance on that. With rises, it'll be even more. You've got this awesome kick tail to do a kick off the top. This is going to be the perfect skateboard, skate park board for me. I'm too old to kick push around a skate park, but I'll tell you what, that'll be my kick push on that. And it'll give me all the speed I want and the actual controlled speed to hit a ramp at the right height, the right speed. And it's going to make such a difference. Also, I'm thinking of playing around with, after I've reviewed it, putting on a double kingpin Goldwing Sidewinder truck, the 10-inch wide ones I have on my Shaka board, the traveling folding board I got, the same trucks, the Ruster trucks, reverse double kingpin with maybe the glow wheels, the white ones, which will then glow at night in the front and carve on a dime, with these beautiful back ones, pretty sturdy, just like a smooth star where the back wheels don't turn. That's going to add a whole new dimension to skate park cruising, or just ramp areas, or where you find some really nice spots to just use it like a slash cross skateboard, you know, carver board, electric skateboard. That's going to be what I'll use it for. It's absolutely going to be fantastic. And I'll test that out by going to the skate park and having a go with the wheels as they are. And we'll test the speed, the braking. We'll put it next to Boosted Mini X. And we might just get the Boosted Mini X up now to show you how it looks together. There you go. So there's my Boosted Mini X. Oh, it's so much heavier. And you can see, obviously you can see with this, there's been a very big influence on the way the decks have been done. Obviously they're, you know what, whoever's designed this deck knows what they're doing. I've had this Booster Mini X for about 2 years now, a year and a half. I love riding it, but when I finish riding it, I can hardly walk. It's this massive spoon deck at the front there that just, you're virtually like riding on the end of a dinner plate. It's just atrocious the way it's designed. This thing has fixed that problem and gone for a much smoother, as you can see, finish on that lip compared to the Booster Mini. And the Booster Mini X looks a little bit bigger because it's in front, but if you actually put that, the Booster Mini is pretty much the same size. I'll just turn it around. It's only about half an inch bigger than the Booster Mini. So yeah. Yeah, we'll turn on and see how the motors sound. I just think it's worth looking at. What's it on? It's on high speed. Yep, okay. Beautiful. Braking is really gentle. And their tolerance is, I'm looking at now, it's near perfect, probably 1 mil out. Yeah, very gentle. Gonna be really nice for the skate park, like I said. Beautiful. It's virtually, it's a great influence on the Booster Mini. I think this has got some merit. I think this thing has an incredible amount of ability to really tick a few boxes and think outside the square, i.e. the skate park and the last mile home. I think before you diss this and say, I don't need that, you have to look at why you need it. So let's get out and have a ride of it. I'll give you some HD video of it now on the table. We'll check it all out. Big thank you and shout out to Base Camp and the team and Tracy and Stephen. I think this is going to be a winner. I think this is going to be something really nice. Ironically, the first board I ever reviewed on my channel, which was 6 years ago, was the FIC Mini, which is a single hub drive motor. I did give it a bad rating and gave it a hard time and said it was just too gutless. Let's see how, I might get that out as well, but let's see how 6 years have gone in technology, hub technology, motors and batteries. And I think this, if it does what I think it's going to do, is going to be a real winner. Guys, thank you so much for joining me today on the Base Camp F11 Unbox. This is going to be something, little James Bond's secret weapon. It'll come into its own at the right time. Guys, till next time, I'll see you in the next video. Till then, happy skating, safe skating, and let's get on the road and check it out. Okay dudes, here we are with the Base Camp F11. We're gonna check it out straight out of the box. Straight out of the box as it is, as it's set up, like not adjustments at all. Give my first impressions on the speed, the power of the motors, that we can turn. So if you get this out of the box, what it looks like, then we'll do some adjustments to it. So let's go for a ride now and check it out. Okay, so straight out of the box, it's rideable, it's fine. It's only on 3/4 battery, you can see, so that'll make a big difference when I fully charge it. What we're gonna do, we're gonna pimp it up a little bit. It's Andrew Penman's customized design. We're gonna get some risers, some 1-inch risers, and whack the wheels up so there's no wheel bite. There is no wheel bite, but the way I carve there will be. We'll put some bushings on the front, some super soft ones, tighten up the back like a smooth star. We'll also get some new bearings in here. I've got my Zealous bearings at home, and then we'll take it to the skate park. But we've got a bit to do now, so let's go to the skate shop.
And I think to myself, what a wonderful
world. We're back at the park after I've just modified the board, pimped it up a bit from the skate shop. We've got the risers in there, and we've also got the new bushings, and I think this will make a lot of difference. It'll be a lot more cavalier, it's going to be a lot more loose, and it'll spin a lot better with the new bearings. And let's check out in the same run and see what it can do. It's a completely different board. It is a completely different board. It's gone from being
was like a tank a little bit, where I couldn't turn it, and a bit, you know, obviously out of the box, not designed to be super loose, to a super agile kind of like street carver, makes a hell of a difference. So if you are going to do this modification for skate parks, I recommend you follow those instructions I did. And yeah, there's no bite. Now, we'll just show you when you hit it really hard, the truck stops it. So it'll flex another half an inch, but it will never touch the deck based on these particular spaces. There'll be in the links in the description field. Let's go for a ride, have a look at the board, check it out. But I want to put you on a little comparison with the Booster Mini X. That's the big brother, the number one board. That's like the most powerful board in this class. Let's do a couple of sprint tests. This is only on 3/4 battery, unfortunately, but I will fully charge it for the next video. But let's do a couple of sprint tests, see how it performs, and yeah, have a look side by side. Let's check it out. This thing's just 5 times more powerful belt drive. Let's do some sprint tests, have a feel of it, see if it carves any better. Just put it against this this. Just do a sprint test now. This booster board's nice, but it's not as agile. And the belts have a huge drag, so there's no way you could ride this on a skate park. But yeah, there you go. Let's look at the base camp. So it builds up. So what this thing does, it's a slow, gradual takeoff on high speed, but it does build up. And when it gets to about 14 k's an hour, you've got plenty of speed. So for a skate park, I think it's gonna be perfect, because you can give it that little push when you want. You're not getting a jerk, you're not gonna flick off the back. Great for that sort of scenario. So let's end up with some music now, guys, and I hope you enjoyed today. Today's rating on this is gonna be a 8.8 out of 10. I would've given it a 9, but I had to do modifications for the wheel bite. And I love this deck though. This deck is just absolutely insane. It's one of the best decks I think I've ever seen. Just beautiful. I've got a new subscriber. So I've got a definite 9 coming up when we get the skate park. I think we can even review that again if it does what I want it to do for a Taylor skate park board, electric board. Yeah, so there you go. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. Safe skating, happy skating, safe skating. See you next video. Let's start the music and let's have a look at the board.
Set upon an argument, I believe we place our happiness in other people's hands. I believe the junk food tastes so good because it's bad for you. I believe your parents did the best job they knew how to do. I believe that beauty magazines promote low self-esteem. I believe I'm loved when I'm completely by. You've got to tell you. the key to your unhappiness. I believe that where the bliss negates the need to be undressed. I believe that God does not endorse TV evangelists. I believe in love surviving death into eternity. I believe in karma, what you give is what you get returned. I believe you can appreciate real love till you've been burned. I believe the grass is no more greener on the other side. I believe you don't know what you've got until you say goodbye.
You're still here? Cool. Listen, why don't you watch some of these other videos I've made in the past along the same lines of what you've just watched in the same kind of category. Enjoy.